Hi, my name is Vicki Vanderwerf. I'm the Associate Director for Residence Life here at Western. Today I'm going to show you how to make Brussels sprouts, which are really simple. And then I'm going to show you also how to make a tortellini bake, something easy, relatively cheap. You can use any kind of pasta, so it can be pretty inexpensive, and easy to do, which is what I appreciate about cooking. So I'm going to start with the Brussels sprouts and then move on. So my kitchen's quite small, so I'm going to show you things as I can. So I'm starting with 5 Brussels sprouts. I live alone, so I try to just eat or cook what I need to eat for that night and then recook other nights. So I'm starting with Brussels sprouts here. What you want to do with a Brussels sprout is take off any of the ends that seem either gloopy. I don't know if you can see that. So take out the outside layer. So I'm going to do that. And then what you also want to do is cut off the ends of the Brussels sprout. Okay, so I took off those outside layers, cut off the end. I'm just going to take off this outside layer that I missed here. And then for them to cook a little bit better, usually I'll cut it in half. So I'll do that. So really simple. So I put those in a bowl. Then what I'm going to do is coat a pan. Can be any pan with either, you know, cooking spray, can put foil at the bottom, but just a simple pan. It can also be just a baking sheet as well. So I have a bowl here with the Brussels sprouts in it. I'm gonna get a couple more. So we're ready to go. And then what you're gonna do is just get a bowl, can be any size bowl. And then you're gonna douse those Brussels sprouts with salt, pepper, and a little bit of olive oil. It doesn't need to be exact, just however much is good for your liking. It can be just a little bit. You don't have to need to overdo it. But that's why Brussels sprouts are so easy. It's just a couple ingredients. Okay, so I have my bowl here. So I'm gonna mix in those 3 ingredients that I shared with you. So just a little bit of olive oil, some pepper, and some salt. I'm gonna mix that up. And then just put those in the pan to bake. So when you're making Brussels sprouts, you just wanna make sure they're sorted in your pan as much as possible, and then cook them for about 40 to 50 minutes. It really just depends on how you like them. If you can see that there, pretty simple. I like mine a little darker, even a little burnt on the edges, so I'll usually leave mine in for a little bit longer. So I'm gonna put those in the oven, again, 40 to 50 minutes on 400 degrees. So I'm gonna put those in now. I'll pause the video and then share the tortellini bake with you here in a second. Okay, so now we're gonna start with the tortellini bake. Again, pretty easy. You can use any kind of pasta. I'm gonna use Cheese Lovers tortellini. This is a 10-ounce bag, but if you wanted to make the full larger dish, you can also do a 20-ounce. There's 5 ingredients. So there's a tortellini or any pasta of your choosing. There's Alfredo sauce, marinara sauce, Parmesan cheese, and mozzarella cheese. So this is super simple. So I have a pot of boiling water on the stove. So you're going to put about 6 cups of water, get your pasta, whatever pasta you choose, bake that or boil that. And then this one only takes 3 minutes. It only takes 3 minutes to make tortellini. So then when that is done, I'm going to take that off the stove and I'll come back and show you next steps. Okay, so my tortellini is done. It's important not to overcook your pasta, whatever type of pasta you use. Also, I think I said 6 cups of water you want to boil it in, definitely 6 quarts. You want to make sure you have enough water to cover the noodles. So I strain the noodles after the 3 minutes, put them in a bowl. So then here's where the other ingredients come in. So normally this recipe calls for 20 ounces of tortellini. I only had 10, or only used 10, because I live alone, so it'll just be me eating this. So normally in the 20 ounce version, it calls for a full can or a whole can of Alfredo. So I'm just gonna use half of this. So I'm gonna put that in now, and I'm just gonna eyeball it. It doesn't need to be perfect. So for 10 ounces, about half of a can of Alfredo. I'm gonna use about a quarter of a cup, or a quarter of, not a quarter of a cup, quarter of the jar of marinara. So the 20 ounce version, the full version, it requires half of the jar. So I'm just gonna use a quarter of that. And again, you just wanna eyeball it, doesn't need to be perfect. Okay. So next up, I'm gonna stir all of this together. So again, this is really simple, really easy to do. I am not a cook, and this one turns out great every time. Okay, so next up, you're gonna get a pan or baking dish. You spray the bottom, make sure it doesn't stick to the bottom there. And you're gonna put that tortellini in with all of that Alfredo and marinara sauce already mixed in. So this is what that looks like. Pretty simple. So next I'm gonna use about a quarter cup of mozzarella. I'm just gonna sprinkle that on the top. So again, doesn't need to be perfect. And then I'm also gonna use about a quarter of a cup of Parmesan cheese. So I'm gonna sprinkle that on the top as well. All right, actually I love mozzarella cheese, so I'm gonna use a little bit of extra and sprinkle that on the top here. You just wanna make sure that it's covered so the cheese can really get in there. Okay, so I'm gonna show you what this looks like. So this is a tortellini bake. So next up, you wanna put this in the oven at 350 degrees, and you wanna let that bake for 15 minutes, and I will show you the final product when it comes out of the oven. Okay, so the tortellini bake has been in the oven for about 15 minutes. I'm gonna show you what that looks like. So 15 minutes on 350 degrees, really easy. And then the Brussels sprouts have been in the oven for about 45 minutes. I'm gonna show you what those look like. So really simple meal to put together, really inexpensive. Again, you can use any pasta for the tortellini. So feel free to substitute whatever pasta you like the most. Hope you enjoyed this. Hope it gave you some good tips. And I'd be excited to hear if you try this in the future. All right, thanks so much.